I often get confused with few common spacey terms like dwell volume, dead volume or void volume, and hence I decided to make a simple video on this kind of various terms. So let us discuss one by one, and in this video I am going to walk you through three important terms, which is dwell volume, which is also called as a gradient volume. The second one is void volume or dead volume, and the third one is the extra column volume. So let us begin with dwell volume, and here is the definition of the dwell volume. So the dwell volume is the volume from the gradient mixer to the head of the column. It includes the volume of the gradient mixer, then the connecting tubing to the pump head and check valves, the tubing between the pump and the injector itself, and the tubing between the injector and the column inlet. So the volume occupied by these different parts of the HPLC system are accountable for the dwell volume of the HPLC system. Now generally the quaternary systems, because nowadays most of the laboratories has the quaternary system, and the quaternary system has a little bit higher amount of dwell volume as compared to the binary system. The quaternary system can have a dwell volume of around, let us say, 860 microliter to around 1000 microliter. But the binary system can have a dwell volume of around 80 microliter to 100 microliter. Now let us also understand what is the significance of the dwell volume and why the dwell volume is so important. As you know that the dwell volume is also known as the gradient delay volume. Higher is the dwell volume, the more will the gradient get delayed during the HPLC run, and that is what it cost you, a delay in the gradient volume, and because of that you may have the delayed retention time, or sometimes you may get the different selectivity for the early eluting peak, and hence it is very important for you to understand how much is the dwell volume of the system, or what should be the limit for the dwell volume of the system in case if you are running the gradient program. So the different dwell volume can result into the different chromatographic pattern and can also result into the different retention time. So more is the dwell volume, you may get the higher retention time. The second term is void volume, and the void volume is also known as the dead volume, and here is the definition of the void volume. The volume from injector to the detector, including the space accessible to the mobile phase in the column. So it starts from the injector and it ends at the detector. It also includes the space which is available inside the column, which can be acquired by the mobile phase. And let us understand what are the components that account for the void volume, and here are the injection volume, volume of the injector, volume of the connecting tubing before and after the column, volume of the end fittings and frits, volume of column accessible to the mobile phase, and volume of the detector's flow cell. Now what is the significance of void volume? So band broadening at outside plus inside the column. So because of the void volume, you cannot avoid the void volume, because you have to connect injector with the column and then column to the detector. You have to inject the sample and you should have the injector for that reason. So you cannot have a zero void volume. You cannot have a HPLC system with a zero void volume. But what is the significance of the void volume? The void volume causes the band broadening of the compound. So greater the void volume, you can have the bigger band broadening, and because of the band broadening, you know that you will end up with the poor resolution, poor response, and maybe the poor peak shape. So it is very important for you to keep your fluid volume as low as possible. The third term is called as the extra column volume, and here is the definition of the extra column volume. So the volume from injector to detector excluding column. This is the volume from the injector to the detector but excluding the column, or excluding the space which is accessible to the mobile phase. It can also cause the band broadening at outside of the column. So the extra volume will consist of the void volume minus the space accessible to the mobile phase in the column. So the injection volume, the volume of the injector, volume of the connecting tubings before and after the column, volume of the end fitting and frets, and volume of the detector flow cell, these are the accountable parts of the HPLC system for extra column volume. So this is how these three different terms can be explained, and each term has its own significance. So thank you very much, and bye-bye.